MovieWeb.com.
Now, you're on Lost and Southland at the same time, yes. And you were just talking about the fact that Southland could go to Wednesday nights, and you're going to be on both shows next season. What is that going to be like to compete with yourself, or would we see Lost and then we can flip the channel and see you on Southland?
Well, I don't know what's going to happen with Lost next season, so I don't know if I'll be against myself. That I can say. I can't, you know, they're so, they don't, everything changes. You know, we're in the 70s right now. Who knows where we're going to be, you know, next year. So, and I'm in the 70s. So I don't know if that'll be a case that I'll be competing against myself. Right now I am, and I'm, you know, spent the last 6 months Hawaii, LA, and I just had a baby, so my mind is exploding. But, you know, I love Lost. It's an amazing show. I was a fan of it from the pilot. So to get on it was really a dream. I mean, really, there were two shows I wanted to be on TV, and this year I got to be on Mad Men and Lost. Those were, like, the two things I wanted to do. So being on Lost is great.
Now, what is it like to come onto a show that is nearing its end, and it already has such a huge following, and then at the same time being on a show that is just starting and starting to get, like, a following? I mean, there's got to be sort of a dichotomy there, and you get to see both ends of that spectrum.
You know what? It's amazingly different, and here's why. Those guys, you know what though? I was gonna say, those guys, it's old hat for them, but they're all really, this is Lost, they're all still psyched to be doing it, you know? And so I was gonna say, all of us on Southland are like kids, you know? But I would say those guys at Lost, those guys in Hawaii, they're really, I think giving them an end date rejuvenated them, you know? So they're not on a show that's in its fifth season, they're like, what am I gonna do in season 9? You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. They know next year is the end. They know there's, at this point, 17 more episodes. So they're pretty gung-ho. So there's not as big a difference as you would think there would be, you know? Everyone's really psyched. We have a little bit more at Southland, like, is this going to go? Since we're not picked up yet, we're like, what's happening? You know, they don't have that, obviously. But they're a good, amazing group of people over there, I really got to say. Very, very welcoming, you know? For a show that's been on for so long and so popular, totally welcoming. And everyone I worked with, which majority was, you know, with Sawyer, with Josh, and, like, he's a great guy, and, you know.
Well, a lot of those guys that have been on the show since it began get island fever being over there, but you don't get that because you're going back and forth, you just said, between Los Angeles and Hawaii.
Which, so I gotta tell you, is a little worse. Because I talked to most of those guys are actually, at this point, the island fever is almost gone because they live there. They have their life there. They have, you know, my wife and my baby inside her belly were here, so it was really hard for me. The flight sucks. It's the worst part of the, I mean, that flight is turbulent ocean. I literally felt like I'm going to fly, and I'm living this show. The plane's shaking, and I'm like, so I had to live through that part of it, but I almost would have rather just been there maybe for, like, permanent with my wife and over there for, like, 7 months. But then, you know, I wouldn't be able to do Southland, so it worked out pretty good.
As far as Lost, do they let you know, at least hint, what you're going to be doing? Or is this something where you're kept totally in the dark until you get that script?
I was in the dark until I got that script every time. When I was hired, it was 2 episodes, and it ended up being 9. When I was hired, literally, it was like, you're going to Hawaii, you're doing 2 episodes, and I was like, oh, that's awesome. And I saw the scripts, but when I auditioned, it was fake sides. I had no idea. There was something. I was like, I don't know what this is. You never get to see, you know, the real thing at the audition. I got the scripts, and I was like, oh, okay, wait, we're in 1970, what? I didn't understand how we got to 77, because I didn't know what happened in the 7 episodes before. You know, you don't get a lot of information at all. And then every 10 days I'd get the new script, and they'd call my agent and say, he's in the next one. And then I'd get the script, and I'd be like, okay, all right, I see where they're going, this is interesting.
Well, I'm interested to know, do you follow what the fans are saying? Because it seems like every week it's like this roller coaster ride where the fans are like, that's not what I wanted to see. And then the next week it totally turns their perception 110 degrees and they're like, oh my God, I didn't realize that's where it was going and now I'm in love with the show again. I mean, do you experience that firsthand?
I don't follow it, no. I don't follow what people... I follow my friends. I have like a group of friends who watch it and I like to hear what they say. I don't follow sort of the general fan base of what they think. But I'd say that this season that's been a lot of the reaction I've gotten. People are like, I don't know where they're going. Oh, I love that. That's great, you know? Is that what people are saying?
That's what I get from, because I don't follow the show myself.
Oh, you don't watch it?
No, I haven't really. I've seen bits and parts of it.
Okay.
But I haven't like been able to follow it from beginning to end. I figured I'd save it all for the last, like when the whole box set comes out and watch it all at one time. You know what?
You'll like it even better watching it that way.
Yeah,
I swear, watch it all in one lump sum. That the show is going to go like that. It has a whole 6-year arc. I know that. But that's cool. That's a good way to do it.
Well, but I have to pay attention to what's going on as far as the fans and stuff, just because we run TV web and movie web and all that stuff. And that's what I've seen over the season is like one episode will come out and the people are like not too excited about it. Then the next episode comes out and they're like raving about it. And like, do you have a lot of people coming up to you and being like, what is going on with this show? And like, I mean, does that ever impede on what you're doing in your real life?
No, it doesn't impede because I'm fine with it, and it happens a lot. I'd say it happens really recently because from like Mad Men to Lost to Southland, now it's all three of those shows. People want to know what's happening right now in Lost, but people want to know if I'm coming back to Mad Men, and people are now starting to be like, hey, that show Southland's really good. So it's you know, people are less fanatical about Southland because it's sort of beginning. The fanatics are Lost and Mad Men are very passionate.
Mm-hmm.
Viewers of those shows are very passionate. But I've gotten a little bit of that with Lost, people confused, and then at the same time people being like, oh, and they're going to get a little more confused in the next couple of weeks and a little more... by the end, a lot of answers. The finale's great.
And you've shot through the rest of the season.
Oh, yeah.
Now, can you talk about the fan reaction last night to what happened last night? Or is that something you'd rather not comment on? Because I had never seen anything like that. It was like, this is the first... Because everybody loves Obama, but all of a sudden... He's preempting Lost, and you have this huge group of people screaming about it.
Wait now, he preempted, but not West Coast.
No, not West Coast, but East Coast. But
I
still,
thought he
they
went
were
8 to 9. Didn't this press conference? Or didn't Lost still come on at 9?
Maybe it did last night, but before it was supposed to come on, there was this big controversy about him.
Oh, really?
Being in the middle of it. Maybe they switched times last night, but this was before it happened.
Because I thought his press, he made sure it was only going to be an hour, because also, well, I know Fox didn't run his press conference.
Yeah, exactly, because of the whole thing.
No, so I didn't know. I thought it was all fine and dandy on East Coast. I thought it aired at 9 and went to 10 and all...
Okay, well, it might have because I didn't look at it afterwards. I was looking at it beforehand.
I think people
like,
were worried
controversy
yes,
beforehand.
That it was going to go over. His press conference, that his thing would go over. I loved it.
Well, I thought it was just funny because I'd never seen anything quite like that yesterday.
People getting sort of like, that's why I thought that that it would end on time. I don't know because, I mean, West Coast, obviously, it was all fine.
Yeah, it ended on time on West Coast. I don't know.
Yeah. So I don't know what happened on the East Coast. I don't know if they ended up, if fans got. And it was a fantastic episode last night. It was a really, really good one. And we had a big death last night. And, you know, one of the regulars, so that's always a big deal when you lose one of the...
Yeah, and I think a word had gotten out about that beforehand was also why.
Oh, it had?
Yeah, like that's something...
Who it was?
Not who it was, but that something big like that was going to happen, and so that's why these people were sweating and, you know... And Obama was going to do something to...
So when our president's speaking, it's like, we can't... And I love that Fox is like, well, you know, we got to air our idol.
Well, what's funny with you too also though is that you are so recognizable because you have been on nearly every single big show in the last, I want to say 10 years. That might be a little bit of an exaggeration, but I mean,
maybe a little bit, not
much, but I want to know, what is that like to have been on so many great shows over the span? Because I mean, you are, it says here that you're part of, you know, the history as far as eating with your restaurant, but also television history is like, I mean, you're an immediately recognizable person at this point.
It's pretty cool. I'm a TV fanatic. So I think, my wife and I watch a lot of shows. So I have the list of shows I want to be on. And I've been on most of them. There's a couple left that I haven't been on that I sort of tell my agents, I'm like, here's what's left.
Which ones are those?
Dexter. I love Dexter. And Californication. Those are two of the big ones. And I was supposed to maybe do some in Californication last year, but I was doing Mad Men.
So and I'm sure if Deadwood was still around, you would have been on Deadwood.
Deadwood was a great show.
I figure you would have fit in perfectly
I
there
love
with all
that
those
show.
Great guys.
Yeah. That definitely was on. But it's amazing. It's really, it's incredible. Like, I feel really blessed. I really mean that. Like, I feel lucky, and I've gotten to do a lot of amazing shows. I've gotten to work with so many different incredible actors. And the thing about guest starring, though, you go in, you know, it's like first day of school, you're, like, scared, and then, oh, this is cool. And then you got to leave. And you got to go to the next thing. And you're like, ah. You know, that's what's great about Southland, is hoping this gets picked up and it turns into something that is more than what I've gotten to do, you know.
Well, I was going to say, if Southland is picked up, which I'm sure it will be, because it seems really popular with everybody that's seen it so far, that you're going to have a more, like, permanent job over here, are you still going to be able to go out and do
That's going to be sort of up to the Southland people. Like, we got to figure that out. We'll see. I'd love to not be available to go out and do the other stuff, actually, right now. I really would. I'd love to sort of sit, set up camp, and be, I'd be psyched to do that. I really would. And then they're amazing. They'd give you opportunities. If you got something, they'd let me sort of be like, all right, go do that. Because it's good for them. You know, to have their actors on other shows, mm-hmm. it's only good for them.
Now, so, what I was going to say, you brought up Mad Men.
Yeah.
Can you talk about if you're coming back? I heard you weren't coming back.
I don't know. And I will be surprised. Matt, who's the creator, is amazing. But like, do you watch Mad Men?
No, I haven't seen that show either.
The first year to the second year jumped a year and a half, and no one from the first year, none of the like non who worked in the office, none of the guest people, arc people came back in the second year, except one came back for 5 minutes, Maggie Siff, who's on Sons of Anarchy. She played like his big girl from the first year. She came back in one little brief moment. So I think he's super into cleaning the slate and starting like a fresh thing, and that's just in my mind, I think that. I think the fans liked me, and I think people responded to my character. So we'll see what happens. They don't start shooting for about 2 months, so.
Would you have any ideas of where you would like to see your character from that show go if they do pick it up, or is that something you don't even ever speculate on just because you can never tell what's going
to
happen?
You know, I got to tell off Don, which was a really big deal for fans of that show, because no one told off Don Draper, and then he punched me. And so he got the last word, and I'd love to come back and just get a little bit in his face again. And I'll let him have the last word again, because he's the star of the show, so he's got it. But I'd love to come back and, you know, have a little something to say about being knocked out.
Well, I'm sure fans are really waiting to see that happen, and I think they're hoping that that happens from what I've read. So
I would dig that. It would be very cool. It's a great show.
I was going to say, it's a pretty exciting time for you, because you're like on three of the best shows on television.
Dude, I know.
But now I want to say, you're also Patrick from Patrick's Roadhouse.
Yeah.
What has that been like for your entire life to be a part of that? Because that's a pretty big deal, too.
You know, it's unfair of me to say this, but it started when I was 5, so it sort of felt like nothing. But I know it's not. Do you know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. It kind of felt like I lived at, you know, I'd go to the Roadhouse all the time. I worked there when I was a kid. I took all my, like, it just, I never realized how big it was until I got older. And I went to New York and went to NYU and I came back. I'm like, the Roadhouse is a big deal. It's been there a long time. And, you know, it sort of was just second nature, though. Growing up to it, it didn't feel like that special. But looking back on it now, it's pretty amazing. Now as an adult, I'm really like, oh, that's cool. You know, I drive by it and I'm like, oh, there's my name. It's been there for a long time.